Welcome to Late Night Church. Hey, my name is Tim Jackson. I'm the pastor of Magnolia Avenue United Methodist Church. I want to invite you in to Late Night Church tonight. First things first, we want to say prayers for Robert and Janet's son, Paul, and his wife. She just gave birth a few weeks early. So let's lift up Robert and Janet and their family. His son and his wife just gave birth to a baby. And we want to pray for that baby because it has it came a little prematurely. So lift them up in prayers tonight. Hey, if you were one of the over 150,000 viewers of Late Night Church over the last 28 days, that is flipping incredible. Over 150,000 views, Late Night Church, over the last 28 days. If you are one of those who has clicked on a devotion, a worship set, a worship service, or an encouraging word, we just want to say thank you. Never have I ever thought that Late Night Church would crack 100,000 views in a month. Never have I ever thought that Late Night Church would crack 150,000 views in a month. And we're getting closer and closer to 6,000 followers here at Late Night Church. Just want to say thank you for making Late Night Church successful. When we started this, it was our hope, it was our prayer to encourage as many people as possible on the internet during the pandemic with the love and forgiveness and grace of Jesus Christ. And you have helped us to do just that. Hey, tonight we're going to talk about a subject we have never talked about before. Tonight we're going to talk about Holy Communion or the Eucharist, the Lord's Supper. It's known by many different names, many different denominations. So I've been studying the ancient church, from resurrection to the first 1,000 years. And in the first 300 years, the focus of the ancient church wasn't the preaching of the word of God. Now, remember, the Bible wasn't first mass produced until about 1450 with the printing press. So the Bible didn't come into being as we know it until about 400 AD. So all they had initially were the writings of Paul and John and Peter, letters, and they had the Old Testament. But when they gathered together, they would recite the creeds and they would take the Lord's Supper. And the Lord's Supper was the center and it was the focus of the early church. And I think over time, the church has gotten further and further and further and further away from taking the Lord's Supper, the Eucharist, Holy Communion on a weekly basis. The ancient church, the first 300 years, they sometimes would take the Lord's Supper daily. And they believed that the Lord's Supper strengthened their faith, strengthened their love, strengthened their hope in Christ and their love for each other. So tonight, we're going to be talking about the Lord's Supper. Hey, Brandy. Hey, I'm a United Methodist Church pastor who grew up a Southern Baptist. And the people who all volunteer at Late Night Church come from many different denominations. We're just brothers and sisters in Christ who love to make disciples and shepherd them well. And we are all connected to strong local churches in our community that serve the less fortunate. That's kind of who we are. Like I said, we're a group of folks from local churches who just wanted to encourage and support as many people as possible during the pandemic. And we've done just that. I know that during the election and the pandemic and the social unrest that we had in our country, we really felt like people needed to be encouraged, loved, and supported each and every day. And that's what we try to do at Late Night Church. So tonight, we're talking about Holy Communion. If you want to follow along, we're going to be in 1 Corinthians 11, verse 23 through 28. 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 23 through 28. I'm going to pray for us, and then we're going to kick it over to Robert and Drew for some worship. Father, we thank you so much for this good day that you've given us. We thank you for your love, your forgiveness, and grace. We thank you for your Son, our Savior, Jesus. We thank you for your Holy Spirit that empowers and equips us to live a life that honors you. We thank you, God, for the printing press that made the Word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God, available to every man, woman, and child on the face of the earth. God, tonight may we honor you, praise you, draw near to you. In your name we pray. Amen. Over to Robert and Drew, and then when they're done, we're going to talk about Holy Communion.
Everyone, welcome to Late Night Church. It's time to worship the Lord. Worthy you, God.
To those
faith, all is stripped away, and I simply come. Longing just to breathe, something that's of worth, that will bless your heart. I'll bring you more than a song, for a song in itself is not what you have required. Search much deeper within, through the way things appear, you're looking into my heart. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, and it's all about you, it's all about you. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I've made it. When it's all about you, it's all about you, Jesus. It's all about you. Endless worth, no one could express how much you deserve. Though I'm weak and poor, all I have is yours, every single breath. I'll bring song in itself is not what you have required. You search much deeper within, through the way things appear, you're looking into my heart. I'm coming back to the heart of about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I made it. When it's all about you, it's all about you, Jesus. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, and it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I've made it. When it's all about you, it's all about you, Jesus. It's all about you. It's all about you, Lord. We surrender to you today. I'm coming back. 'Cause I'm coming back to the heart of worship. And it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I made it. When it's all about you, it's all about you, Jesus. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, and it's all about you, it's all about you. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I've made it. And it's all about you. it's all about you. We just praise you now. Just pray as we continue this service, Lord. I just pray that we realize that everything is about you. It's all about you. We surrender our lives to you, Lord. We give you all honor and praise, for you deserve it. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Robert. Thank you, Drew. Hey, tonight we're coming out of 1 Corinthians. I'm going to type it in there. Chapter 11. Verse 23 through 27. Verse 23 through 27. Let's talk tonight about Holy Communion. About Holy Communion. Paul says this: "For I received from the Lord, and I passed on to you. The Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'This is my body, which is for you. Take and eat, and do this in remembrance of me.' In the same way, he took the cup and he said, 'This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this in remembrance of me. And whenever you drink it, in remembrance of me, for whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he returns.'" The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Let's talk about Jesus for just a couple of minutes in Holy Communion. Jesus wanted his disciples to remember him. You and I. Jesus wants his disciples to remember him. Jesus wants us to remember his life, his teachings. Jesus wants us to remember his sacrificial death on the cross that pays for your sins and mine. Jesus wants us to remember his resurrection, with which he presented himself to his disciples. Jesus also wants you and I to remember his promised return to take his disciples away with him into eternity. Jesus promised that he was going to prepare a place for us, and that if he was going to prepare a place for us, he would come back and receive us to himself. With that in mind, Jesus instructs his disciples to take Holy Communion often. "For I received from the Lord what I also passed on to you." The Lord Jesus, on the night that he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after the supper, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." So one of the ways we take communion at Magnolia Avenue is each week at the end of the service, I remind them that we need to remember and we need to take and eat, for this is the body of Christ. And then we take the bread, we dip it in the cup, and then we receive the bread and the blood of Christ. The church, the body of Christ, we've done this for over 2,000 years. For over 2,000 years, the church has taken Holy Communion, or Eucharist, or the Lord's Supper. You see, when we as the body of Christ take Holy Communion, we remember the life, death, and resurrection and promised return of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Taking Holy Communion, it strengthens our love for Jesus. Taking Holy Communion strengthens our love for each other. Taking Holy Communion strengthens our love for those who are genuinely less fortunate. The Bible tells us that that the Christians are to take Holy Communion in remembrance of Christ. And I would tell you that the table of communion is open to everyone. That the table of Holy Communion is open to everyone. All who love Christ are welcome to the table of Holy Communion. All who love Christ are open to the table. If you've not placed your faith, hope, and love in Jesus, then this is your opportunity to place your faith, hope, and love in Jesus. For God so loved the world that he sent his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but receive eternal life. For God didn't send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. The table of Holy Communion is open to all who love Christ. All are also welcome at the table of Holy Communion who have earnestly repented of their sins. You see, sins, it breaks our relationship with God, and it causes a separation between us and God. If you haven't repented of your sins, turned from your sins, then before you receive Holy Communion, you should confess your sins. There is healing, restoration, and renewal and forgiveness when we confess our sins. The first Bible verse I ever learned was 1 John 1:9. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just and will forgive us of our sins and will cleanse us of all unrighteousness. So all are welcome to the table of communion who love Christ. All are welcome who've earnestly repented of their sins. And all are welcome who seek to live in peace with their fellow man. All are welcome. If there is no peace between you and your family and friends and neighbors, this is an opportunity to acknowledge that. Jesus said that if we were at worship and we realized that we had something against our brother or our brother had something against us, then you and I should leave that place of worship and go and be reconciled to that brother or sister in Christ and then come back. The table of Holy Communion is open to all who love Christ. The table of Holy Communion is open to all who have earnestly repented of their sins. And the table of Holy Communion is open to all who seek to live in peace with their brother and sister in Christ. James 5:16 says, therefore confess your sins to one another and pray for one another so that you may be healed. When we confess our sins, Christ forgives us, but it also sets us free and heals us. Does he still love us even if you're mad at him from the past? Yes. All right, so here's the deal. For God so loved the world. The Bible tells us that God's love for us is greater than the stars above the earth. The Bible tells us that God's forgiveness is as far as the east is from the west. I understand how sometimes we don't understand why God allows some things in our lives, but we still trust in the Lord even through those difficult times. And I would say this, you can bring your anger, your frustration, your fears, your worries, your sins to God. Jesus said, come to me, all you who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Draw near to God, James said, and he will draw near to you. In Hebrews, it says, we can approach the throne of grace with confidence. How can we approach the throne of grace with confidence when we know that we're sinners and imperfect? Because Christ died on the cross to pay for your sins and mine. When we place our faith in Jesus, he takes away all our sin, all of it, yesterday's, today's, and tomorrow's, and he gives us all his righteousness. So when God sees you, Patricia, when God sees you, Brandy, he doesn't see your sin. He sees the love and forgiveness and grace of his Son. So we take Holy Communion when we love Christ. We take Holy Communion when we've earnestly repented of our sins. We take Holy Communion when we seek to live in peace with our brother and sister in Christ. And then we come forward, we take the bread and we dip it in the cup and we receive Holy Communion. For 2,000 years, the church has done this. For the first 300 years, the pulpit wasn't the focus. Remember, the Bible wasn't put together until about 1450. It was put together by Athanasius in about 360 AD, but it wasn't put together in a printing press where it was available to everyone until about 1450. So they didn't have the Bible, but what they had were the stories of Christ's life, death, and resurrection that were written down, and they had those. In just a moment, I want to pray for you. And if you have never placed your faith, hope, and love in Jesus Christ, let me encourage you to do that tonight. I didn't get to church until I was 26 years old. I made a lot of mistakes as a young adult. I made a lot of mistakes as a teenager. I hurt a lot of people. But when I made it to church in August of 1995, one of the things I realized was that God loved me. No matter what mistakes I had made, God loved me. And no matter what mistakes I had made, Jesus paid for all of those mistakes on the cross. And the only thing that was keeping me from an abundant and eternal life was standing up and placing my faith and hope and love in Jesus. It took me about 6 weeks. But in early October 1995, I came forward at church, kneeled down, surrendered my life to Christ. You don't have to be in church to do that. My wife, when she was 15 years old, she had been to a conference. And that night when she came home in her bedroom, she kneeled down by her bed, confessed her sins to Jesus, and prayed to receive him as Savior and Lord. 1 John 1:12 says that if we believe in him and receive him, we become the children of God. And if we believe in him and receive him, he gives us the right to become the children of God. So no matter where you are right now, you could stop and pray a prayer like this. Lord Jesus, thank you for loving me. Thank you for forgiving me. Thank you for dying for me on the cross. I surrender my life to you, Jesus. Come into my life. Set me free. Teach me how to follow you. Teach me how to share my faith. Surround me with people who love and encourage and support me. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Amen. If you prayed that prayer, let me know. I'd love to hear that. I'd love to hear that. So Holy Communion, it remembers the life, death, resurrection, and return of Jesus. When we take Holy Communion, it strengthens our faith, hope, and love in Jesus. When we take communion, it strengthens our love, compassion, and mercy for each other. I want to encourage you. When was the last time you took Holy Communion? When was the last time you took Holy Communion? I want to encourage you to connect with a church that takes Holy Communion this next week or two so that you can celebrate Jesus and receive Holy Communion and be strengthened. The table is open to all who love him, to all who've earnestly repented of their sins, and to all who seek to live in peace with one another. Hey, tonight we have small groups at 9:30. In our small groups, Brandy, we share our highs and lows for the week. We just say, hey, here was my best parts of my week. Here was the bad parts of my week. And here's how you can pray for me. It's that simple. It could take a minute. But if you're not connected to a small group, I'll put our small group link in the text box there. You are welcome to join us tonight in small groups. Normally, we kind of hang out for about 30 or 45 minutes. Then we pray for each other and we go home. I know some of our late night church people are from all over the world, from Kenya, from Alabama. That's a different state in the union right there. From Kenya, from Alabama, and from all around the world, we invite you to join us for small groups. Thank you so much for joining us. Hey, if you're one of the 150,000 folks who has viewed Late Night Church over the last 28 days, let me say thank you so very much. Help us to continue to encourage and love and support as many people possible on the internet with the good news of Jesus Christ. Have a great night. God bless.